हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो अशर। एज प्रॉमिस्ड अ फ्यू डेज बैक आई हैव कम टुडे टू शेयर विथ यू द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ जुपिटर एंड व्हाट दे रिप्रेजेंट। वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ सैटर्न एंड मार्स एंड हैड प्रॉमिस्ड दैट आई विल कम बैक टू यू विद द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ जुपिटर। It is very important to understand aspects because they are as important as a planet placed in the house and only so much little. And so because there is so much importance of the aspects or the drishti or the influence of a planet on another house or a sign or another planet, hence it is important to truly understand the aspects because the placements are definitely most important. Where a planet is placed, but the aspects are equally important, slightly less important maybe than planet placed in a house, but they are of equal importance and their manifestation is crucial to understand the results holistically. If you are ignoring the aspects of a planet while placing your natal chart or through the aspects, what yogas they bring, what doshas they bring, then you will not be able to comprehend astrology and you will not be able to comprehend astrological results or effects that come out of a placement of a planet. So aspects are crucial and Jupiter's aspect is one of the most crucial part of astrology because by virtue of just Jupiter's aspect, so much of malefic results or effects in the horoscope can be reduced. Many a times a lot of malefics can create havoc in our lives. But it is only through the Jupiter's aspect that we are saved. If you look at from an astronomical perspective, Jupiter is one of the outer planets. So we have Sun, then you have Mercury and Venus, and these are the inner planets. Mercury and Venus are inner to Earth, and after Earth come Mars, then Jupiter, then Saturn, the three other planets which are utilized in astrology. And so these are the outer planets, Mars, Jupiter and Saturn. Of these, Jupiter is the largest planet. If you compare, while even Saturn is large, but if you compare between the size of Jupiter and Saturn alone, if Saturn is the size of a say football, Jupiter is the size of a bus. Okay, so the bus that we take to work and the school, like a school bus, you know. So that is the difference between the size of Jupiter and Saturn, and Jupiter is closer to the Earth than Saturn. So the influence that Jupiter has on Earth is much more than what Saturn can have at a prosperity bringing level, at an abundance bringing level. And Jupiter in a way is shielding Earth from Saturn. If Jupiter was not in between Earth and Saturn, then definitely there would be a challenge. One thing from an astronomical perspective, lot of asteroids and comets keep coming into the solar system, and Jupiter, because of its huge size, attracts a lot of these astronomical entities like meteors and comets to itself and then takes them in and destroys them. But if Jupiter wasn't around, then all these projectiles would come towards Earth and would have harmed Earth, and life on Earth would have extinguished. And that's why Jupiter is also called, one of the names of Jupiter is Jiva. That means a planet which gives life, and this is the way Jupiter gives life, because we know that the energy to sustain life comes from the Sun. So the soul itself gathers its energy from the Sun itself. Now when you look at the planetary manifestation, we are told that Mars is the general of the king. King is Sun. And Saturn is the soldier. Saturn is the follower. You give orders and Saturn will follow. But if Sun has to establish rules, who is the vice counsel to the Sun? The vice counsel to the Sun is Jupiter. And that's why the vice counsel of a soul is Jupiter. And these are represented by the 5th and the 9th houses. The first, 5th and 9th house, as we know, are the houses of Dharma. And in the Kalpurush Kundli, they are represented by 5 signs, Aries, Leo and Sagittarius. So these constitute dharma, duty, responsibility and fire, because fire is associated with following or having the fire, the energy to go and do your duty. And hence these three placements, the first, fifth and ninth, are very, very important. And Jupiter, by virtue of being given these aspects, the fifth and ninth aspect, has a special meaning to these, apart from having the seventh aspect as well. So if you look at the fifth house is also the house of the Sanchita Karma. The Sanchita Karma is all the accumulated Purva Punya, which means all the goods and bads, whatever Punya you have acquired so far, it is all accumulated. But the fifth house is also the house of gains, which means your gains will come from what Purva Punya you are carrying. And Jupiter, by virtue of also being the Karaka of the second house and the fifth house, is also stating that second house being the house of prosperity, gains and abundance, Jupiter will help you get the gains and prosperity. And the fifth house being the house of Purva Punya also, as well as Jupiter being the Karaka, means Jupiter is the Karaka or the wisdom provider on how to handle those challenges will keep coming to you through your Sanchita Karma. Because a part of your Sanchita Karma, the Prarabdha Karma, will be given to you through the ninth house, which is ruled by Sagittarius, which is the sign of Jupiter. So Jupiter has a special meaning in astrology, and it has and various shlokas have talked about the aspects of Jupiter. Let's look at one of the shlokas which talks about what does the aspect of Jupiter bring to our life. The planet Jupiter has other names: Guru Jirvo, Deva Mantri, Devatana Purohita, Devajya Adirasanu, Brihaspati Riti Smrita. The planet Jupiter has other names like Guru, Jiva, Deva Mantri, Deva Purohita, Devajya, Angirasanu and Brihaspati. So these names give us the various qualities of Jupiter, and each of these qualities are brought forth in our lives, and through Jupiter's placement, Jupiter's ownership of various houses, depending on what ascendant you are born in, and Jupiter's aspects as well. So let's look at one shloka which talks about what Jupiter's aspects bring, what flavor Jupiter's aspects bring in our lives. Whatever untoward effects have been declared as a result of aspects by planets or either of the luminaries at the time of the commencement or conclusion of an eclipse, the intensity will be toned down and they will prove auspicious if only Jupiter's aspects falls on the same, just as blazing fire is put out by water. So the most malefic of aspects, or the most malefic of conjunctions that is placed in a house and which can wreak havoc in our lives and in our house, in that particular aspect of that house, can be brought down substantially only by Jupiter's aspect on the, or just by Jupiter's aspect on that particular dosha or the house. And so the shloka says, just like fire is put out, blazing fire is put out by water, same thing will Jupiter's aspect on a dosha or a house too. So that is how important and how powerful Jupiter's aspect is. So the fifth aspect of Jupiter is about bounty, it's about giving, and it's about giving you the perspective of life. And that's why fifth house being the house of education also, and the fifth house also being the house of taking risks and what you like to do. So Jupiter tells you or gives you the wisdom at a base level, at a mundane level, how to live a life at a day-to-day level. One is being conscious of that I'm present, but who you are, that ability to know who am I can be given only when you rise spiritually through the learning given by Jupiter. So the fifth aspect of Jupiter is at a mundane level, at a more materialistic level, and it tells you that to use education and to use your wisdom on a day-to-day basis to attract bounty towards you, to attract riches towards you. And that's why fifth house is also the house of gains. And Jupiter, by being the significator of the fifth house, is establishing what the fifth with the fifth aspect of Jupiter represents. Bounty and gains is what Jupiter tells you. However, Jupiter also tells you that without education, 5th house also being house of education and power, 5th house also gives you the power. But the 5th house is the 8th house to the 10th house. So, your gains will not come through without upheavals, without ups and downs, unless you use your wisdom, you use your learning. And that's why the 5th aspect of Jupiter represents abundance, prosperity, but also doing your duty. And also about using your wisdom and doing ethical things. Because the 5th house is the 5th to the Lagna, but it is also the 4th to the 2nd house, of which again Jupiter is the Karaka. So the materialistic gains will come to you, high earnings will come to you, and materialistic pleasures will come to you if you have ethical conduct, because 2nd house is also the house of principles, what values you have. So the earning of the Lagna, the materialistic earnings of the Lagna is the 4th house, materialistic earnings of the 2nd house is the 5th house. So, if you use your principles, you use your values and you lead a life of values, at a mundane level, you will be able to handle day-to-day things with the wisdom that education will bring you, that power of education will bring you. So, learning and using wisdom on a day-to-day basis to attract bounty, to attract prosperity is what the 5th aspect of Jupiter represents in our lives. Sar Guru Gehe Surye Guruna Drishte Sada Vidvana. The person with the sun in the Jupiterian sign receiving the aspect of Jupiter will move in royal circles, will serve the best of rulers, be wealthy and learned. Sun goes into a Jupiterian sign such as either Sagittarius or Pisces, then the person will move in higher circles. Here king is coming to Jupiter, which means the king is coming to gain wise counsel. And so the company that such a person will keep will be the company of kings or people in high authorities. And hence the company will keep the company of rulers and serve the rulers. And so sun going into Jupiter sign is also a sign of the highest of high authorities coming to you for consultation, for wisdom, for wise counsel. And so 5th house becomes very important because it is the 9th house to the 9th house. So, and because it is the 8th house to the 10th house, so if you are somebody who is looked as somebody who is wise and who can give wise counsel, the upheaval that come into your job could be something good. You may be chosen as somebody who is a wise counsel, and day-to-day mundane things will be taken away from you and becoming the advisor to the king himself, to a CEO, to the MD or the highest in authority in the land can be the role that is given to you if the 5th aspect of Jupiter is a strong, powerful aspect on a good sign and on a good yoga. So for example, if Jupiter is placed in the Lagna where it gets the highest directional strength, and that is the other special thing about Jupiter. Jupiter is the other benefit apart from Mercury, which gets directional strength in the Lagna. So, if Jupiter is placed in the Lagna and its 5th aspect is on the 5th house of gains, and if Jupiter is strong and if the 5th house is strong as well, a friendly sign and has a yoga, then such a person can enjoy a huge amount of power and authority by being the wise counsel that the highest authority depends on. So, the 5th house is about power, influence, taking educated decisions, and on a mundane level, keeping the gains of or getting the gains of your wise counsel, your wisdom, and attracting abundance in your life, all around abundance in your life. Now, what is the 7th aspect? The 7th aspect is not a special aspect in general terms, because every planet has the 7th aspect. But Jupiter's 7th aspect becomes special in the sense that firstly, Jupiter is a planet which talks about wisdom, it talks about wise counsel, but without taking everybody along, without being somebody who can manage relationships and day-to-day dealings with the 7th house represents. And Jupiter, mind you, is a planet which gains directional strength in the Lagna. Jupiter gaining special or gaining directional strength in the Lagna means that it is directly aspects the 7th house from there, which means without relationships, without understanding and keeping and using your wisdom and how to handle relationships and day-to-day learning and day-to-day working, day-to-day issues, day-to-day challenges, and facing them, the day-to-day challenges with wisdom, you will not be able to attract the goodness in life. And Jupiter also represents putting out the fire, the putting out the blazing fire with water, which means the peace and tranquility will come to your life only when you are able to handle relationships better and deal with people on a day-to-day basis, keeping the rapport in mind. And that's why Jupiter gets exalted in Cancer in the fourth house of mental peace. So peace will come to you when you have a strong Jupiter and you are using your wisdom, your wise counsel to deal with people on a day-to-day basis. If you use your wise counsel, if you use your Jupiter well on a day-to-day basis, then you're and through that you will be able to maintain relationships, have better relationships, have better contacts and have better connections, then you will attract bounty, you will attract mental peace, you will attract happiness. And that's what the seventh house, seventh aspect of Jupiter represents. It's all about being somebody who uses wise counsel to handle day-to-day issues, day-to-day challenges in life. Shobhana karma matimana sarvesha priyo vipul kirti kongru haste bhana guruna drushte manasvicha. I translate, the sun in a sign of Saturn with Jupiter's aspect will cause association with auspicious or good deeds. The native will be wise, will show liking for all, be widely famous and intelligent. The sun, which normally is not well placed in Saturn sign such as Capricorn or Aquarius, but if it gets Jupiter's aspect, then it is said that you will attract bounty. You will be known for your good deeds. You will be somebody who will be known as somebody who is who's ethical and who does good deeds. You are kind, you are generous, and you will be liked by everybody, and your societal connections will grow. Saturn represents and owns the 10th house and the 11th house. The 11th house is the house of societal connections, and Jupiter is also the Karaka of the 11th house, which means that if Sun goes even in the sign of Saturn but with Jupiter's aspect, then you can shine in society. You will be liked by people and your reputation will be that of a good person. So Jupiter's aspect on the Sun, even in a tough situation for Sun, can bring that about. But what is the Sun? The soul. And the soul's journey in this life about related to prarabdha karma is the 9th house. So the karma accumulated, out of the accumulated sanchita karma, the karma for this life is represented by the 9th house. So the soul having the prarabdha karma in this life is represented, what the soul's journey is, or the karma of the soul is in this life, is the 9th house. So the 9th aspect of Jupiter is about how you live out your prarabdha karma, you do your karma through wisdom and higher learning. 9th house is also the house of higher learning. Higher learning is not about getting masters in a subject or becoming MBA or doing a PhD. The higher learning is about how to lead your life more judiciously, keeping in mind that the soul's elevation is the purpose of life. And so being spiritual about your needs, you're spiritual about your deeds, having gratitude and trying to elevate your soul and doing those deeds which will elevate it and take it closer to the supreme energy is what the 9th aspect of Jupiter represents. And because the 9th house is also the house of gains and high gains, but 9th house also being the house of spirituality, so the spiritual gains that will come to you in a life is the 9th aspect. So wherever Jupiter's 9th aspect falls, you should be looking at doing things for the humanity, for everybody else, and always trying to do better deeds in that house. So if Jupiter's 9th aspect falls on the 10th house, for example, if Jupiter is placed in the second house, then the 9th aspect of Jupiter falls on the 10th house, then your career, how you lead your career, should be with ethical standards, with moral standards, and choose a profession or link your profession to something which is more spiritual, where you are helping others. And through the happiness that you get, the peace that you get, that you're helping others, or what how your work contributes to the world, through that the spiritual level elevation of your soul happens. So the ninth house of Jupiter is also all about being grateful, being spiritual, doing more, gaining more knowledge, as much knowledge as possible about the particular house, and then manifesting that with gentle goodness for others and gaining more and more wise counsel in that. So if you are the advisor in finance, then accumulate the highest learning in finance so that you come across the best wise counsel that your leaders, your CEO or MD can get. If you are somebody who is in sports, then be the best sports coach and have in-depth knowledge and learning about the sport, the sports person, the different facets of that industry, so that you can give most best wise counsel to the person that you are going to coach. And because of you doing your dharma, which you are born for, with the highest learning, you will also gain spiritual elevation. Both the mundane or the domestic life is combined with spiritual knowledge or spiritual entity for you, which means that without living your day-to-day life, without living the various ashramas, including the grihastha ashrama, if you're not living the ordinary life, but leading the ordinary life, gaining the experience and gaining the experience of how to handle different challenges, different issues in day-to-day life, only then will your spiritual elevation will happen. So if you're not dealing with your day-to-day life spiritually and gratefully and using your higher learning, your spiritual elevation will not happen. So wherever the ninth aspect of Jupiter falls, it is gains, very high gains also. But the ninth house is also the house of long distance travel. That means your soul will go long distance, or the highest elevation of the soul will happen when you will be focusing more on the spiritual side of life rather than the mundane and the materialistic side of life, which to an extent the fifth aspect of Jupiter represents. So whenever you are looking at life, you look at life from a materialistic prism, but don't forget the spiritual prism and balance the two. And that's why the fifth house and the ninth house are exactly on the either side of the seventh house and the lagna. They're equidistant from the lagna, they're equidistant from the seventh house, which is dealing with the others on a day-to-day basis. And because they are well balanced, the fifth and the ninth house, so Jupiter says balance between the materialistic aspect and balance between the spiritual aspect. Don't forget your spiritual elevation on your day-to-day life. Keep in mind that one day we will all die. One day all our mortal existence will finish, and only the spiritual dimension will remain. And that's why the ninth house aspect is about knowing the difference between the materialistic side and the spiritual side. So while leading your life on a day-to-day basis, ensure that you don't refrain from, or you don't move away from, the ethical part, the spiritual part. Keep in line with what the Supreme Energy wants. Give your time to the praise of the Lord. Give your time for meditation. Give your time, some of your time at least, to be with the Lord. And wherever the ninth aspect of Jupiter falls, do good deeds in that, about that house. Do good deeds about that particular relationship. Do good deeds about what the house represents. And then only your spirit will also elevate and your soul will elevate. So that's what the ninth aspect of Jupiter means, that being grateful and look for spiritual elevation of yourself through where the ninth aspect falls. So friends, Jupiter is a harbinger of prosperity, peace, mental happiness and spiritual elevation, and gaining the highest learning and the highest experiences through the highest experiences and varied experiences, and then elevating the soul. So look at where Jupiter is placed in your horoscope and what houses it aspects. Where the fifth aspect falls, you will be able to get better gains, better prosperity, better output materialistically from that house, but absolutely without compromising on wisdom, without compromising on learning and knowledge you need to do. The ninth aspect of Jupiter, wherever your ninth aspect of Jupiter is falling, is where you need to be more grateful about and be more giving, be more large-hearted, and look at the spiritual dimension and do it to elevate your spiritual journey. And so be more giving and get more learning about the particular dimension of that house. And through the higher learning and through higher contribution, they both go hand in hand. Higher learning, and so that you are able to contribute more, give back more, give highest wise counsel, your spiritual elevation will also happen. So friend, this is my analysis about the various aspects of Jupiter, the 5th, 7th and 9th aspect. Please like this video, please share this video, and if you are looking for a personal consultation from me, please reach out to me at the links given below. Until we meet some other time with some other video, this is your friend astrologer and guide Irfan signing off. Ciao.